Hello, good morning everyone. Today we are going to understand what RAM is, what its uses, what is cache, buffer, swap, how to clear buffer and cache. We will see practical examples of all these things which I'm going to discuss here. I'm going to clear these three, four topics like RAM, buffer, cache, VM state, SAR, swap, virtual memory. In terms of Linux perspective, so let's get started. You have seen the agenda, which I have also discussed. What is RAM? When the word memory comes in our mind, memory means the faculty by which mind stores and remember information. This is for human memory. We are here talking about the computer memory. Computer memory is any physical device capable of storing information temporarily or permanently. Like we have example of RAM. RAM is a volatile memory, stores information for OS, kernel, processes that makes a system faster. It is a multi-chip module. In this picture, we can see 1, 2, 3, 4 chips that can be slotted on the motherboard. We have swap partition or I'm going to show you through example. If we have one server in my production environment that is having 4 GB of RAM, my application team requested that they have upgraded their application and that application is require 8 GB of RAM. So we have one solution that either we have to purchase another 4 GB RAM and can slot over there on the server if it is supporting 8 GB of RAM. Second, if it is not supporting, then we have to replace the server. A part of this, we have one feasible solution, that is swap memory. What we can do is, as it is showing in the picture, from the hard disk we can take 4 GB of space that will replicate like a RAM. So we have 4 GB of RAM, 4 GB of swap, now 8 GB, and we can host the application. So request can be fulfilled through swap memory. What is buffer memory? You must have heard many times what is buffer. So it is a temporary holding place for data. Here in the picture you can see I have 6 processes. For example, I have some space for buffer as well. So it is being continuously used or utilized by the kernel. We have cache. Cache is a combination of physical or hardware. It could be hardware. It is of three types, L1, L2 and L3. It is the fastest memory and it genuinely creates a difference. I'll show the thing how it is benefiting the kernel and how it is saving the time of the kernel at the last by the practical example. Now we have seen all the things like what all are these. Here practically we can see that how much is RAM, how much is the total memory I do have, how much is free, how much is shared, and how much is buffered and how much is caching. So when you are executing free command, it will show you 6 fields, and one good option that is of buffer and cache, and you can easily calculate that this much amount of memory is free, 364120 KB. Now I have some user friendly options, like if you will use -m, it will show you in MB. Here I'm using -m. It is showing me 770 MB is used, 88 MB is free. With the help of -g, you can see in a human readable format, like 770 MB is used, 509 MB is free, and 2.1 GB total, 2.1 GB is free. I have to read one log file, that is installer log2. Here installer log2. I get this this file and I track the time, how much time has been taken. 0m0.302 seconds has been taken. Like you can say, it should, system could take only this much amount of time. Now the information which I have get one time, it has been stored in the cache of the system. If I'll execute the second command, second time the same command as I have did here, time cat installer dot log. So it is taking only half of the amount, the time which have been taken earlier, only the half of that. That is 143 seconds only. And here it is just like negligible time only. Now we are here to clear. If in terms of anyone asking to clear the buffer and cache, how we can do it? Here you can see 235356 KV has been utilized by cache. I will execute this sync command with echo proc sysvm drop caches. It will free up my space from 90964 KB to 175400 KB. This is only to clear page cache. If you want to clear dentries and inodes, you have to execute sync command with echo to proc sysvm drop caches. This much amount of the free space you will get, 317396. It is just like 20, this much amount you can get. You can calculate in MB or GB. Now, if you want to clear all these things like page cache, dentries, and inodes at one go, you should use sync command with echo 3 in the same directory or file. You can get some more space. Why it is showing this much less space? Because I have executed all three commands one by one. So thanks, friends. Now I'm going to show you some practical, like how. I'll log into the server. This is root. First, I will show you free command. Like if I use free, it will show you me like this data, total used free shared buffers cache. Again, if you want to see in human readable format, use hyphen m hyphen h. I will show you how to clear this cache and buffer and all. So you can notice here 2.5 MB of cache is utilized. I will use sync command echo 1 proc pages has been cleared. Cache pages 205 MB to 147 MB. So you can see earlier you were having 244 MB of free space. Now you are having 203 MB of space. If you want to clear dentries, you should use again that sync command. Sync with echo 2 proc sys VM drop caches. Check here how much amount has been released. You are having here 302 MB. Now you are having 305 MB. Again, you have got some more space. If you want to clear all the things, all the pages and caches, dentries, everything, you should use sync command. You are having the same amount because I have executed one and two command simultaneously. So if you want to, if you don't want to use these two commands, you can use this command only at one go. So you will get the same amount of free memory. So thanks friends, thanks a lot for watching this video.